Hello students, welcome to the EPG Paathshala. In today's lecture, we will learn about Earth's major biomes, distribution and biotic components. The learning objectives are the concept of biomes, major terrestrial biomes of the world according to the World Wildlife Fund classification. To understand the distribution and biotic components of different biomes. As discussed earlier, the biomes are large geographical regions of the earth. They have a characteristic type of biotic community that is shaped by the climate of the region. The biome classification system was developed by the Nature Conservancy and the World Wildlife Fund. There are 14 terrestrial biomes, which are also known as the major habitat types, range from wettest tropical rainforest to the hottest desert. In terms of the relief of the different regions, they range from the mangrove forest by the sea to the alpine meadows of the Himalayas. Geographic realms in the major biomes. Each biogeographic realm contains a range of major biomes. For example, the Indo-Malayan, Oceanic and Neotropical realms are dominated by tropical forest and grassland biomes. The polar realms relate to the Palearctic and Nearctic, which contains higher proportions of tundra and boreal forest. While the Afrotropics are dominated by tropical grasslands, the Oceania realm is composed mostly of low tropical islands and is dominated by tropical forest and tropical grassland biomes. In this table, the major biomes have been tabulated. They are the tropical and subtropical moist broadleaf forests, the tropical and subtropical dry broadleaf forests, the tropical and subtropical coniferous forests, temperate broadleaf and mixed forests, temperate coniferous forest, boreal forest, taiga, the tropical and subtropical grasslands, the savannas and shrublands, the temperate grasslands, savannas and shrublands. And then we have the flooded grasslands, savannas biomes. Mountain grasslands and shrublands are a unique type of the biomes. The tundra is a treeless cold desert. The Mediterranean forests and woodlands and scrublands have high biodiversity. Deserts and xeric shrublands, where the annual precipitation is less than the evaporation, and the mangroves are in the coastal regions of the world. In this diagram, you will see the distribution of the tropical and subtropical moist forests. They are concentrated mostly in the Amazon basin in South America. The second region having the tropical rainforest are the Congo basin and other lowland regions of Africa. In Asia, the mainland and the islands in the Southeast Asia have the tropical rainforest, and the northern tip of Australia also has the unique type of the tropical rainforest ecosystems. The tropical forest ecosystems, they cover just 10% of the Earth's total land area. Then we see the distribution of seasonally dry tropical forest, which is adjacent to the rainforest biome. As you can see in this diagram, the seasonally dry tropical rainforests are in South America. The seasonally tropical dry rainforests of Asia and Africa. Their distribution is shown in this diagram. Then it is very interesting that the Amazon is the single largest remaining tropical rainforest of the world. And they contain a very high biodiversity. About 10% of the world's known biodiversity, including endemic and endangered flora and fauna, are found in this Amazonian tropical rainforest. And there is a very large amount of the discharge from the rivers to the oceans. If we see the Amazonian rainforest distribution, the 60% of the forest is contained within Brazil and Peru, 30% in Colombia, 10% in minor amounts in Venezuela, Ecuador, Bolivia, Suriname, and French Guiana. Some general characteristics of the tropical rainforests. Now we will discuss some general characteristics of the tropical rainforest, which have a very stable temperature around 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. They are wet, the annual rainfall exceeds 2000 millimeter per year. Some places maybe the rainfall is 10,000 millimeter per year. The forest floor is dark because only 2% of sunlight reaches the forest floor. The soils are nutrient poor, acidic in nature, and they show stratification, that is, vegetation is organized into vertical layers. The top constitutes the canopy. Each layer has a unique biotic community containing animals adapted for life in that particular layer. In this diagram, we see the stratification in the tropical, subtropical, moist forest. The emergent layer consists of very tall trees, which reaches heights of 45 to 55 millimeter. The dense canopy layer further down absorbs most of the sunlight. On the trunks and stems grow the dense lianas, lichens, mosses, ferns, and flowering plants. There are large woody climbers extending from the ground to the canopy. The understory lies between the canopy and the forest floor. The biodiversity of the tropical rainforest biome. There are several millions of different type of animal species, insects, reptiles, amphibians, and mammals in these forests. Mammals and reptiles are predominantly arboreal because they live in the canopy of the trees. They are nocturnal. Birds are present in great diversity in the upper strata of the rainforest. There is a great diversity of the invertebrate species. Now we will discuss about the tropical and subtropical dry forest distribution. The dry forests are found in southern Mexico, southeastern Africa, central India, Indochina, Madagascar, New Caledonia, central Brazil, the Caribbean, the valleys of northern Andes, along the coast of Ecuador and Peru. The biodiversity in this forest, that is deciduous trees, are predominant. During the drought, a leafless period occurs, which varies with the species type. These forests are less biologically diverse, are home to a wide variety of wildlife, including monkeys, large cats, parrots, various rodents, and ground-dwelling birds. In Madagascar dry forests, there is a high degree of endemism and a large number of relict taxa. The Atlantic dry forests of South America are fairly dense, and the most remarkable tree is Cavernalesia arborea. The dry forests of Hawaii, they harbor the native hibiscus trees and several rare endemic plants. The dry forests of central India and Indochina are notable because there is a diverse large vertebrate fauna. Now we will discuss about the tropical and subtropical coniferous forests. These forests occur predominantly in North and Central America. Low levels of precipitation and moderate availability of variability in temperature. There is a diversity of the species of conifers. The Mesoamerican pine oak forests are most extensive subtropical coniferous forests. There is a rich diversity of plant and animal species, especially birds, conifers, reptiles, and amphibians. In the Mexico region, the coniferous forests are richest and most complex subtropical coniferous forests. So, continuing with the discussion on temperate broadleaf and mixed forest, The eastern Himalaya broadleaf and conifer forests are found in the lowlands to the foothills of the Himalayas in North India, Nepal, and Bhutan. The western Himalayan temperate forests are made up of western Himalaya broadleaf forests, the western Himalaya subalpine coniferous forest. The Russian forest temperate forests are very distinct. High level of endemism in plants and invertebrates form a critical area for the conservation of Amur tigers. It is richest and experiences a wide range of variability in temperature and precipitation. Species of oaks, beech, birch, and maple are the main components in this forest. There are four layers of the vegetation in this forest: a canopy composed of mature, fully sized dominant species, a slightly lower layer of mature trees, a shrub layer, an understory layer of grasses and other herbaceous plants. Most biodiversity is concentrated close to the forest floor. Birds like broad-winged hawks, cardinals, snowy owls, and woodpeckers are also found in this biome. Mammals include white-tailed deer, opossums, porcupines, and red foxes. This biome plays a crucial role in the global carbon budget. Now, another type of biome that we are going to discuss is the temperate coniferous forest. These are common in the coastal areas of the regions that have mild winters, heavy rainfall, or inland in drier climates or mountain areas. Temperate rainforests can be temperate coniferous forests or temperate broadleaf and mixed forests. Many tree species like pine, cedar, fir, and redwood occur in this forest. They sustain a very high level of biomass in any terrestrial ecosystem. The Sierra Nevada ecoregion in USA is home to the giant sequoia, the Sequoia dendron gigantea. So we are going to discuss about the boreal forest, Taiga. Boreal coniferous forests are found between 50 degree north to 70 degree north and are regulated by very long dry cold winters and short warm summers. The global distribution of boreal forest is shown in this diagram. We have a very extensive area covered by this Taiga forest in northern part of North America. And then we have a very large region having this Taiga forest that is in Eurasia and Eurasia the northern. So we are going to discuss some more features of the boreal forest of Taiga. The dominant trees of the boreal forests are evergreen spruces, firs, larches, or pines in most areas, while cedar and some species of deciduous trees, betula and populus, are also common. The characteristic animals in this biome are moose, wolverine, lynx, and several kinds of snowshoe hares, finches, and wood warblers. There is a large migration of caribou or reindeer, and intact predator assemblages can still be found in some regions. So we have another very interesting biomes that are the tropical, subtropical grasslands, savannas, and shrublands. This biome has a rainfall ranging from 90 to 150 centimeter per year. The savannas of Africa and Campos and Llanos of South America and in Mediterranean climate, which is dry summers and relatively warm and wet winters. The largest areas of savannas are found in Africa. The tri-dual savannas of grasslands occur in Southern Asia, including Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, and Nepal. We are going to discuss some of their characteristics. They have a continuous or near complete cover of a mostly grassy herbaceous stratum. The tree or shrub strata vary from a total canopy cover to open grassland. There is a marked seasonal contrast with periodic annual rainfires typical of dry season. The soils are mostly nutrient poor soils. This rhino represents, we are explaining the diagram. This rhino represents a lowland tropical savanna biome. It is in South America, the most threatened tropical savanna in the world. It is a large region that occupies the center of South America and is biologically rich. It is the second largest South American biome, and the Cerrado is among the 36 terrestrial hotspots of biodiversity. So first, in this biome of temperate grasslands and savannas and shrublands, we learn about their distribution. These temperate grasslands include the pampas of South America. The prairies of North America are a very distinct biome in the rainfall region of 225 to 75 centimeters per year. Then the temperate grasslands of Eurasia are the steppes, and the temperate grasslands of South Africa are known as the velds. The climate is typical continental in this biome, which is long and cold winters and hot summers. Biodiversity in these habitats includes a number of large grazing mammals and associated predators. In addition to burrowing animals, numerous bird species, and a great diversity of insects. Now we move on to the discussion of another type of biome, which are known as flooded grasslands and savannas. The flooded savannas and grasslands occur in Everglades, Pantanal, Sahelian flooded savannas, Zambian flooded savannas, the sub-Sahelian flooded grasslands and savannas. Expanses of mangroves and desert vegetation comprise portions of this ecoregion. Among the threatened mammals present in this ecoregion are leopards, Asiatic wild ass, and striped hyena. The run of Kutch has the flooded grasslands in India. Flooded grasslands occur in the run of Kutch, Gujarat. So we move on to the biome that is known as the mountain grasslands and shrublands. These biomes are found above the tree line, that is the upper limit of tree growth. Alpine tundra occur in mountainous regions around the world. The Puna and Paramo in South America, subalpine heath in New Guinea and East Africa, and the steppes of the Tibetan Plateau. The mountain grasslands of Tibetan Plateau support intact migrations of Tibetan antelope and Tibetan wild ass. The tundra biome distribution has been shown in this diagram. The tundra is a treeless polar desert that is found in Alaska, the Canada, Russia, Greenland, Iceland, Scandinavian in North Hemisphere. Some distinguishing characteristics of tundra biome are: it has long, dry winters, extremely frigid temperatures. Most precipitation falls in the form of snow during the winter. The soils are known as the histosols, rich in organic matter, and antisols with little profile development. The top 15 to 60 centimeter soil thaws in the summer and freezes in winter. And beneath this soil is permanently frozen parent material, which is known as permafrost. The tundra vegetation is composed of lichens, mosses, grasses, sedges, heath, as well as dwarf shrubs. The animals that are very characteristic of tundra are muskox, caribou and reindeer, polar bears. The Arctic hare, the lemmings are predominant animals. Now we discuss about the Mediterranean forests, woodland and shrublands. Their distribution is shown on the global map. The Mediterranean forests are found in the western United States and the California. They are a distinct biome in central Chile. In Mediterranean basin, its Mediterranean forests are found, in the Cape region of South Africa, and some of the Mediterranean forest and woodland and shrublands are found in southwestern Australia. The characteristic features of Mediterranean forest, woodland and shrublands are, they have a high plant diversity. The shrub communities can be quite species rich and diverse. And in the case with those occurring in mountain slopes and the upper margins of desert plains in the North America, they may include prickly pear, acacia, sangue, or a tree woodland. The lizards and snakes are common fauna in chaparral, though mammals may also be many, such as grey fox, wood crats, kangaroo rats, and small rodents. The finbos of South Africa show high degree of endemism. Another striking biome is desert and dry shrubland. The deserts occur in specific latitudes, that is 25 to 35 degrees north and south of the equator. The vast land of Sahara in North Africa, the Arabian Peninsula, the west coast of South America, the parts of Australia, India, southwestern United States are the typical areas of deserts. A desert biome can be defined climatologically as the sum of all the arid and hyper-arid areas of the globe. The deserts are dry places where less than 250 millimeter of rain falls in a year. So the deserts and dry shrublands, the plant forms range from typical low shrubs to some very distinct plants and lichens in areas with the fog. The reptiles make up one of the dominant animals in the desert biome, and the second group is represented by burrowing animals. Snakes are important because they are predators and they control the rodent populations. The biomes, that is mangroves, these mangrove ecosystems are found in the intertidal zones of sheltered shores, estuaries, creeks, backwaters, lagoons, marshes, and mudflats along the tropical coastline of Asia, Africa, Australia, and America. This mangrove dominates the tropical tidal swamps. The Sundarban is the largest tidal halophytic mangrove in the world. It lies on the isle deltas of Ganga, Brahmaputra, and Meghna rivers of the Bay of Bengal. To conclude this lecture, we are able to learn about the biome classification that divides the terrestrial world into 8 biogeographical realms and 14 biomes. The tropical rainforests, they cover about 6% of the Earth's total land area. And we have the largest tropical rainforest in the Amazon basin of South America. There is a high diversity of animal and plant species in tropical rainforests. The savannas in Africa have world's richest fauna of grazers and browsers. The tundra is a treeless polar desert found in the high latitudes in the polar regions. Deserts occur 25 to 35 degrees north and south of the equator. Evaporation exceeds rainfall. Thank you.